Welcome, I'm Rajendra Salokhe from India. In the previous video, we have seen that Jerome attack, which was one of the attacks which you can never think of. So here again, a similar attack, non-thinkable, is Croskey attack. Croskey Gambit is called, not attack, but Gambit, okay. It's an attack actually. So Gambit, it arises in Alekhine defense. Now Alekhine defense starts with this e4 and knight f6. It's not advised for beginners to play Alekhine because it violates the basic principle of the opening, that never move a piece twice. So here he immediately gives threat with e5 and you have to move the knight again. And again he gives a threat and again you have to, so about three times you have to move the knight. So it's not a, people don't suggest it for the beginners. And you have to study very carefully. But this is Croskey attack, you can try, because what happens is knight to c6. He ignores this threat to the knight and let the knight go. And he takes the knight, e cross f6. This is Croskey attack, Croskey gambit. So black gives gambit. So obviously black should win. Why should he give gambit? Otherwise it's not winning. And very few games are played like this. I could find two games. One played by Croskey himself. That will come next. And won this. And not many people are playing this. It's a good attack, it seems. So we were in this position. Take this. Now what do you think? Which pawn should take this pawn now? Now actually G cross F6 is the best move. I have shown it into some another this thing game. I think it was Karokan, some variation was there. So this is supposed to be the best move because your rook can go on G file, which is totally open. So however your castle is this thing disturbed, and actually in these two games I found that black did not castle. Black did not get opportunity to castle. So he plays d4, plays d5, knight c3, and he places his rook on the open file g8. Okay, so queen to d3 threatens this h7 pawn, which is again vulnerable, isolated, and no support is there. Now black again does not bother for this pawn. He lets it go. So black plays e5. Now he plays d cross e5, d4, threatening the knight. He plays e cross f6, thus taking the double pawn. One of the double pawns is gone. But he keeps his attack here on d cross c3, queen e4, check, bishop e6, b cross c3, d cross f6, queen cross f6, queen cross f6, bishop to d2, he long castles. So long castles means he gets again this d file open for his rook. So black is controlling two files, d and g. Rook is the best thing to place on the open file, so two files he has occupied. And if you see the development, black has developed much. Bishop has got a long diagonal availability. It takes out the bishop, then rooks are connected. Bishop can move into this direction. This white bishop is well developed. Queen is in central position. This knight is in a correct position. While black has not developed his bishop, knight or rook. Only this bishop and queen. This rook is also now, he can place this rook on b5. Queen cross h7, so he crosses this pawn. Captures the pawn, knight to b4. Now if white takes the knight, then his rook is gone. So this pawn is pinned in, he cannot take the knight with this pawn. And now this knight is threatening this c2 pawn. If it can somehow come to c2, then it will fork the king and rook. Presently, queen is there, standing. Now what black other thing he can do is he put his bishop here on f5. So that it threatens both queen and the pawn, and this pawn will go. But to prevent that, white plays this. Now this is disturbing the castle and actually no good move, because this bishop can capture the pawn. But he tries. So he rook cross d2 is a bold move again. He captures the bishop here. So bishop versus two pawn is the situation. King crosses d2. So bishop versus rook and two pawns. White is ahead, in fact, in material. Bishop to h6 and check. Now he has to go on giving checks, otherwise this rook goes. His rook has no support, it is hanging g8. But see, now black will not give any opportunity for that. He goes on giving checks and checks. Bishop cross g4 check. f3, queen to e5 check, king to f2, queen to e3 check, king to g3, bishop to f4 check, king to g2, bishop cross f3 check, king h3, queen e6 check, king h4, queen g4 and checkmate. So don't give opportunity to white to capture this rook here on g8. Now see next this thing. Example, this game is played as black Croskey himself, on whose name this gambit is. E4 and F6, E5 knight C6, E cross F6, G cross F6, knight C3, D5, bishop B5, rook G8. Rook is placed on the open file G. B cross C6 check, B cross C6. Now what happens is by crossing this again, he can place his rook on the B file, which is open again for the black. Now white castles, A6, D4, bishop G4, knight C6, E5, D cross E5, F cross E5. Now this effect of the double pawn is gone now, it becomes a single, and now black has three islands, this one, this two and this three, and two pawns are isolated. As against, pawn structure of white is good because it's got only two islands and all the pawns are on the level. Queen to e2, bishop e7. White wanted to capture this. This is a vulnerable pawn. But again, black is not supporting this pawn. Instead, he could have put the bishop here on g7. But he doesn't want to disturb the open file. He puts it here so that king is protected. This pawn has become vulnerable again, can go. Rook to d1. Places his rook on the d, which is open file for white. f5. It's 3. Bishop to h5. g4. F cross g4. H cross g4. Rook cross g4. Check. King to f1. e4. Knight e5. See how it is threatening with the pawns. It's got a good chain, in fact, here of pawn. Rook h4. Wants to give check from here. H1. He plays f3. E cross f3. Knight cross f3. Queen to d6. Again, queen wants to take part into this area of white. Bishop e3. Rook h3. Rook h3. So he can capture this knight also. Knight to e4. Queen e6. Knight to g5, threatening the queen. Bishop cross g5. Bishop cross g5. Now with bishop cross g5, this now black queen has got absolute pin with the king. So actually in such cases there is no solution than to capture the exchange the queens or take the queen. But this fellow Croskey has a solution. He takes this knight, rook cross f3, and gives a check. Now king has to move, king to e1. Now gives rook to f1 and check. So king cross f1. This is called deflection technique. Now this queen is attacked by the bishop, or even can capture with the bishop and queen is gone. Queen cross e2, king to g1, queen to g4 and check, king f2, king to d7. It takes king to d7 to avoid attack of this and free this rook, so that it can place the rook on f file here and give check to the king. Bishop h6, queen f3, check, king to g1, rook g8, check, bishop g7, rook cross g7, check, king h2, queen to g2 and checkmate. So this is what the Croskey attack is. Very dangerous, mostly black winning. And Alekhine defense, as suggested, should not be played by the beginners unless studied well. So thank you for watching, keep watching, and if you are not subscribed, please subscribe.